بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن أحسنتم أحسنتم لأنفسكم وإن أسأتم فلها فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة ليسوءوا وجوهكم وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوا أول مرة وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا. لا تهنوا وتدعوا إلى السلم وأنتم الأعلون والله معكم ولن يتركم أعمالكم. إنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو.
تقال العسار العظام به ويغد الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر الإله.
In the days that we live in today are not going to be studied by the Ummah in 50, 100 years from now. And do not think that we are going to be any different, that if we sit back and we sell our religion and we become weak and we submit and we become afraid, do not think that they're not going to say the same thing about us. Let us look to our past. Let us look to the heroes. Salahuddin al-Ayyubi rahimahullah. Let us see what made them different. Let us see how they were able to put tribal pride aside. Let us see how they were able to unite the Ummah and to stand as one. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has told us about the days that we are living in today. And who of us doubts that these are the last days that we're living in? How could it not be when we see these signs happening before us? But he gives us glad tidings. And he also gives us forewarnings that this will be a time of tribulation and fitna. It is a time that every single prophet warned his nation about from the time of Adam alayhi salam until the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that this would be the time of the fitna, when a man would come who will be known as the Antichrist, Al-Masih al-Dajjal. And a man will rise from this Ummah whose name will be Muhammad ibn Abdullah, and he will be Al-Mahdi. And then will come Isa alayhi salam. We as an Ummah have to be prepared. How many Muslims intend to join the army of Imam Mahdi? I am sure that every Muslim has this intention, this niyyah. But what is the reality? Do you think it's going to be so easy that you're going to just be able to sign up and enlist? You have to know your past, you have to study your present, and you have to prepare for your future to know who he is going to be. We have to be ready and realize that it's not something so easy that you can just say, I want to do this. As the Prophet ﷺ told us, that verily, when you see this army, go out to join it, even if you have to crawl upon ice, for verily he is the Khalifa of Allah, he is Imam Mahdi. When we are given heroes of the Ummah, we fight them, we repel them. We find in the past Salahuddin was called a deviant. He was called a troublemaker for not making deals and truces with the Kufar. Yet who is remembered as the hero? Who is remembered as the man? Who is remembered as the one who held high the flag of La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah? It is not the one who sold his deen. It is not the one who did not know his past nor prepared for his future. The ones who will be remembered are the ones who are sincere, hold fast to the book of Allah. They have love for this Ummah. They have concern for this Ummah. They don't sit back. They work and they work hard and they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us now decide for ourselves who we are going to be and how we are going to be remembered. Are we going to be the hypocrites who turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or are we going to be the ones who grant Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala victory? And he grants us victory, and we will hold high that flag, and we will be with the armies marching from Khurasan with the black banners, joining Imam Mahdi and liberating Al-Quds from the hands of these Zionist pigs. May Allah the Almighty allow every single one of us to be sincere when we say that we want to be the ones who assist this Ummah.
وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة ومن رباط الخيل ترهبون به عدو الله وعدوكم وآخرين من دونهم لا تعلمونهم وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة ومن رباط الخيل ترهبون به عدو الله وعدوكم وآخرين من دونهم لا تعلمونهم الله يعلمهم وما تنفقوا من شيء في سبيل الله يوفى إليكم وأنتم لا تظلمون وإن جنحوا للسلم فاجنح لها وتوكل على الله إنه هو السميع العليم وإن يريدوا أن يخدعوك فإن حسبك الله هو الذي أيدك بنصره وبالمؤمنين